There are many choices with breast augmentation, but obviously one of the most important and controversial is which type of implant do you choose? There are two types, obviously. There's saline, which is basically a silicone rubber bag filled with saline. And there is the new generation silicone gel implant, which is a, quote, cohesive implant. A cohesive implant just simply means the silicone gel is made in a more firm fashion, meaning if you cut the implant in half with a knife, literally, it separates like congealed or cold jello. So there are two choices now that are both approved by the FDA for augmentation of the breast. So how do you choose? Well, obviously, you need the help of your surgeon to educate you about the differences, and I will try and do that briefly now. Saline implants are going to be a little firmer and a little less soft and compressible than silicone gel. The silicone gel implant is a much more compressible implant, such as this is a saline implant, and if I squeeze it, it doesn't squeeze as tightly as the silicone gel implant, which is much softer as far as the ability to squeeze it. And that is a major variable in why most women, 85% of women in our practice, choose silicone gel. For one simple reason, it's softer and more natural. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the saline implant. It gives you the augmentation that you want, but the character of your breast is firmer. Some people don't mind that, and certainly many women have a very nice result with saline. And so the choice is really yours. And then it comes down to your comfort level. There are different issues involved in following the breast that's been augmented with saline versus gel. For instance, if you have a saline implant, the implant is either inflated and okay, or it deflates and you know it. In other words, your breast deflates. You know the breast is smaller, and therefore you know the saline has come out of the implant because of typically a small pinpoint hole. Many times, saline implants will have little folds that move and create a small, tiny hole, and that is typically the reason for the failure of the saline implant. The saline is dissolved in your body, and you simply replace the implant. The good part about that is you know if there's something wrong with the implant, and you carry on with normal mammograms and normal breast surveillance for the rest of your life, just as you would had you not had an implant. Except, of course, when you go to have a mammogram, there's special views that are done with patients who've had breast augmentation to confirm that you've seen all parts of the breast. So that is one of the benefits of a saline implant. When it comes to the silicone gel implant, the FDA has requested and suggested that all women get an MRI instead of a mammogram every 3 years to assess the integrity or the outside appearance of the implant, because a mammogram will typically not show whether a cohesive silicone gel implant, which is what we use now, has ruptured. So if this implant, the silicone gel implant, is in your body, even if it may be, quote, altered along the surface, because we don't really know if it truly ruptures, because again, it's cohesive, it's like thick jello, the MRI will show any defect in the implant. And so that's why if you do silicone gel implants, you have to be a little more careful in looking at how the implant integrity is with an MRI. It's not a law, but we certainly as plastic surgeons want to follow the FDA requirements. So you have two different options, and the differences are that one is softer and a little bit more part of your breast, silicone gel, than the saline. The choice is yours, and it comes down to a comfort level. Most patients will succeed in achieving their goal with either implant. Then it comes down to when you feel it and you look at the implant and you consider what size difference you're trying to change in yourself, which is the best implant.